H.C. Verma, Chapter 9, Question Number 20. A ball of mass 50 grams moving at a speed of 2 meters per second strikes a plane surface at an angle of incidence 45 degrees. The ball is reflected by plane at equal angle of reflection with same speed. Calculate A. The magnitude of change in momentum of the ball. B. The change in magnitude of momentum of the ball. If we denote the mass of the ball by m and its speed by v, then the magnitude of the initial momentum of the ball is mv. Since after the collision, the speed of the ball remains same, the magnitude of final momentum of the ball is also mv. The initial momentum of the ball is directed at an angle 45 degrees with the horizontal. Therefore, the horizontal component of this momentum is mv cos 45 degrees. Also, the vertical component of the initial momentum is mv sin 45 degrees in vertically downward direction. If we take the horizontal direction to be x-axis and vertical direction to be y-axis, then the initial momentum vector of the ball can be written as mv cos 45 degrees I cap minus mv sin 45 degrees j cap. After the collision, the magnitude and the angle the momentum makes with the horizontal remains same. Only the vertical component of the momentum changes. Therefore, the final momentum vector of the ball can be written as mv cos 45 degrees I cap plus mv sin 45 degrees j cap. The change in momentum is given by final momentum minus initial momentum. Therefore, change in momentum vector is final momentum vector minus initial momentum vector. Subtracting the two vectors, we get 2 mv sin 45 degrees j cap. Putting the value of sin 45 degrees, we get the change in momentum vector is equal to root 2 mv j cap. Putting root 2 is equal to 1.4 and the value of m and v, we get the magnitude of change in momentum vector is equal to 1.4 into 0.05 into 2 or 0.14 kg meter per second. This is answer to part A of the question. For change in magnitude of momentum of the ball, we need to subtract the initial magnitude of the momentum from the final magnitude of the momentum. But the magnitude of initial and final momentum is same. Therefore, the change in magnitude of the momentum is zero. This is answer to part B of the question. In order to request solution to any question from H.C. Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.